So next up, Visual Studio fans, it's time to talk about turbocharging your testing environment. And here to give us a quick demo of some new enhancements to Visual Studio, please welcome Kendra Havens and Mandy Whaley. Hi, ladies. How are you?
How are you? Oh, hello. So good, Sana.
Good to see you. Welcome to Microsoft Build.
Thanks. Great to see you.
So Kendra, can you tell me what's new in testing land? What have users been saying about testing in Visual Studio?
Absolutely. So you actually want to jump into a video right now? I have a code coverage demo for us.
Let's do it. We love demos.
Nice. So we now have cross-platform code coverage support on Linux with .NET Test. So this is useful for developers who need code coverage reports from WSL, like I'm using here, or their CI/CD machines that are targeting Linux. So currently we support Ubuntu, as you can see, and also Alpine. And we have many more on the way, including Fedora, CentOS, OpenSUSE, Debian, and Mint. So here I can run .NET test dash dash collect code coverage to generate a report, and I get some feedback at the command line, and I can open this in Visual Studio to view my code coverage reports. So once I do that, you can actually see blue highlights for what lines are covered by tests and red for what isn't. So you can kind of see in my production code what's highlighted, what's covered, and what's not. I can also get feedback from Linux servers running in Azure DevOps with the same kind of command line, and we're experimenting with how to show a diff of how a PR impacts code coverage, which is a bit more interesting information than just shooting for sort of an arbitrary percentage. I want to know how the new code is affecting my quality. So what is the trend with these changes? So you can dig into details with what lines are covered per file and whatnot. And as always, we're also making unit testing in Visual Studio better. So a recent addition was allowing console.writeline to appear in the test explorer to get a little extra detail for your tests. And we have some smart truncation around long log files that reduce freezes and get you unblocked. And we also preserve things like clickable links, your source links, so you can easily navigate from the test details pane. We have collapsible regions. I can click that hyperlink that I have in my output, and it will open up for me. So all easy to navigate.
Awesome. That's really nice to hear all the changes in Visual Studio for testing. Can you give us, drive it home. Why is code coverage so important for developers?
Absolutely. So it's a helpful metric to ensure better code quality, and maybe not if you're targeting like an outright percentage, but more of a trend to monitor if you're building up technical debt or not. So we're trying to make it easy to get those metrics for better code health from our tools.
All right. Code health is important. All those changes you showed in Visual Studio to make it easy to navigate the output of your tests is important. So we talked about unit testing in that demo, but that's just one kind of testing. Mandy, can you tell us about another kind of testing, UI testing? What's available out there for that right now?
Yes, absolutely. We are working on the Playwright open source library, and this is a project to help developers with end-to-end testing for modern web applications. So Playwright makes it really easy to create your integration tests and do that early in your development process and get started testing across all the different browsers.
So if I've never used Playwright before, how would I actually, you know, what's the easiest way to get started with it?
So one of the great things about Playwright is that it's really designed to be very developer friendly. And you can use it in whatever language is your preferred language. So JavaScript, TypeScript, Python, Java, C#. You can even use it with the Test Explorer in Visual Studio. And the best place to find all the information about Playwright is at playwright.dev. And there's quick starts, different things you can do to start using it in your project. But I'd love to show you a quick Playwright demo, if we can hop into the demo.
Definitely, let's do it. We love demos.
All right, so we're starting off in Visual Studio Code, and I'm gonna launch the Playwright Code Gen tools. So this is gonna open up a window where you can see the code being generated. We're doing it in JavaScript, but we can choose what language we want. We're going to actually navigate to the GitHub webpage, and you'll start seeing that code appearing that's recording our actions and creating tests based on things like navigating to the pet page, entering things in the text box, clicking on elements. And what's really nice about this is it makes it easy for developers to start building these end-to-end tests early in the development process. They don't have to learn a lot of new tools. They can record something quick, build it into their pipeline, and then know as they're building and deploying that their application's behaving the way that they want it to. And like I said, again, you can see we're changing languages. So there's great support for Python, Java, JavaScript, and C Sharp.
All right, that's really awesome to hear. So as a developer, how can I go about adding Playwright to one of my existing projects?
Yeah, so you can use it from Visual Studio Code. It also integrates with GitHub Actions and the Test Explorer in Visual Studio. Okay. And we're always working with our community to improve Playwright. So if you go to playwright.dev, give it a try, and we'd love to hear your feedback about what you need to help with your testing journey and you know, what we could add to Playwright that would help you out.
All right, like we said, it's open source, so you can give us your feedback. Both of you, if you could, you know, give one kind of best practice about testing for teams, what would that be?
I would think I would say that, you know, if you're really wanting to delight your customers, your users, and give them a great experience, you need high quality code. So we're working on building developer-friendly tools that are going to help you do that.
All right. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you on.
Thanks.
Pleasure to be here.
All right.